When a woman is busy with her political issues, the children are vulnerable. The home is prone to attack. These are cases where we hear and see of female children being sexually harassed. This is because women neglect their duties as mothers and occupy themselves in political issues. What God has joined together, let no man put asunder. But I'll put it in my own way. What God has joined together, let no form of politics actively involved in quotes put asunder. A woman is supposed to be there for her family, especially her children. Not only physically, but also emotionally. This does not imply that women should not engage in politics, but not the essence of being actively involved. In a case where the child is just growing, you find out that the main character needed is the mother. I know my opponents may like to say that the fathers are there. But mind you, the word is housewives and not house husbands.
Who is a woman? She's a mother. She's a wife. She is a daughter, a daughter-in-law. She's a comforter. She's a counselor. She's a nurse. She's a nanny. Ladies and gentlemen, you will agree with me that if this wonderful characteristics of a woman is applied into the political sector of our country, there will be a remarkable difference. I will not forget to mention Dora Akunyili. She was the one who introduced the doctrine of necessity when Nigeria was without a ruler. When the men were silent, when they were in a state of confusion, she came up bold and spoke for our country. When President Umaru Musa Yar'Adua was sick, it is with reasons, these reasons and many more, that I am proud to oppose.
She's a home builder and not a breadwinner. When a woman is actively involved in politics, the role of a mother, a home builder, and a wife is defeated.
Men can entrust women with the ability of running a home. Why then can women not be projected into the political affairs of the society? On this point, I'm proud to oppose.
Thank you very much. If you are just joining us, the motion again is women should not be actively involved in politics. And our moderator for today is Deborah. A round of applause for Deborah.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, greetings to you and welcome to the continuation of last week's edition on Growing Up. I am Chukwukwe Deborah Kwesi-Sochukwu of Federal Government Girls College Ikorubitong. I am the Deputy Head Girl of Federal Government Girls College Ikorubitong, and I am also the moderator of this special event. The topic of this debate is women should not be actively involved in politics. Proposing this motion is Federal Science and Technical College Uyo, and opposing this motion is Federal Government Girls College Ikorubitong. Let's give a round of applause for the participants. Permit me to introduce the panel of judges. On my extreme right is Mr. Okonundin, Mr. Gabriel Etim, and Mr. Abasidon Akai. I call on the accurate timekeeper to give us the time formation governing the debate.
Thank you, moderator. Hello, viewers. My name is Ifre Christopher Akonko, a student of Federal Science and Technical College, Uyo. I am SS3. I am the Deputy Head Girl of Federal Science and Technical College, Uyo. Please listen carefully to the time information governing this event. The lead speaker has 4 minutes. The first supporting speaker has 3 minutes, and the second supporting speaker has 3 minutes. Finally, for the reply speech, the lead speakers have 2 minutes each. The first bell is a warning bell, and it simply means you have 1 minute left to summarize the point. The second bell means your time is up. Please adhere to this, to the time frame. I wish you the best. Thank you.
Thank you, our accurate timekeeper. Now let's listen carefully to a brief address from the chief judge of the panel.
Debate is all about jaw, using your jaw to communicate to the world the best way to live. Debate is all about avoiding confrontation. Internationally, it is accepted that terrorism could have been a thing of the past if we had tried to dialogue, which brings about peace. That's why you see here Ikorobi Tong and Uyo sitting down, learning how to dialogue as a means of bringing peace to the world. As the last week, the lead speaker came on stage, the lead speakers came on stage, and the first speakers came on stage. Today, we are going to hear from the second speaker and the summarizing speaker. Thank you very much.
Starlets,
superstars of tomorrow.
Are you motivated?
Motivated, motivated, motivated.
Walking integrity.
Dignity for all.
I hereby call on the second speaker from the proper team.
Observing the existing order of protocol, my name is Edidion Tom. I am a student of Federal Science and Technical College, Uyo. I am strongly in corroboration of the motion, women should not be actively involved in politics. I stand here to buttress this motion. Child training. Child training is the act of directing a child in positive ways of behavior. It involves care, correction and discipline, which can be given by parents. It is often said, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he shall not depart from it. Like my colleague has said earlier, it is also said that when you train a male child, you train the family, but when you train the female child, you train the nation. This saying means that if you don't train the male child, the family will suffer, but if you don't train the female child, the entire nation will suffer. So it is the duty of every woman to give her child a proper home training. And if a woman is expected to carry out this duty, where is the time for her to be actively involved in politics? In my own point of view, I agree that a woman should be involved in politics, but not to the extent of being actively involved. Also, if we take a close look at the family picture, we will notice that, naturally, most children are closer to their mothers than their fathers. And in the case of a girl child, we know that there are certain issues that a girl child would discuss with the mother that she will not be able to discuss with the father. Let's take, for instance, her first menstruation. Here we see that the girl will not be able to tell the dad that she's having a heavy flow or she's having a menstrual pain. But with the mother, she is free to express her feelings. And in the case of the mother always being busy with her political career, who then would the girl discuss her personal issues with? This situation can also give the child the impression that the mother does not care about her welfare. I know my opponent would like to say that a woman who is involved in politics can come back from work to cater for her children's needs. But I want to make this clear that the topic does not just say involved, but actively involved. The word taking part, doing an activity, busy and lively, defines the collocated word actively involved. For a woman to be actively involved in politics means that she is giving her political career nearly all her attention and time. So she won't be able to come back from work to cater for her children's needs because she would decide to use the remaining time left after work in relaxing from the tiredness of the day's job. Finally, may I tell you, ladies and gentlemen, if you are pressed in the society for your good conduct and good manners, please thank your parents, especially your mother, for playing an excellent role of a mother by training and nurturing you and not by being actively involved in politics. I hope that with this point of mind, I have been able to convince you all beyond any reasonable doubt that a woman should not be actively involved in politics. Thank you.
I call on the second supporting speaker from the opposition team.
Standing on the already existing order of protocol, I am Coco Basti Victoria on the opposing team. My first speaker has defined the word woman as we've heard. She has spoken on the abilities of a woman in her home. If these her abilities can be added in the political arena, a woman will be known as a political leader. I heard my opponent say that no child would tell her father she's having heavy flow. I'm so sorry to say, my father was the first to know when I was menstruating. Not because my mother was not there, she was there, but I decided to tell my father because I'm closer to my father. Now, my second speaker has spoken on how women of the past and present have added to the political, economical, agricultural, and social status in the country. With this, I make reference to Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala, Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala helped Nigeria strike a deal with the Paris Club in order to pay off a portion of Nigeria's debt. She tackled the said problem with great intelligence, and by so doing, she was appointed as Minister of Finance for Nigeria. What I'm saying and what I will continue to say is that a woman can stand on her own with little or no help from a man. My second speaker has explained that politics is a unisex game. Oh yes, politics is a unisex game. It is within the constitution of Nigeria that every citizen of Nigeria at the age of 18 and above are allowed and permitted to vote and be voted for. These rights include the women, and these rights we cannot be denied. So nobody, not even my opposite gender, can wake up one morning and take these basic rights from us. That is why I say women will not be silent. We will not be intimidated by anyone. We know what is important for our lives. So, ladies and gentlemen, it has become a national consciousness, even among the male gender, that a woman has proved herself capable of making a remarkable difference in the country. Denis Osadibe urged women in his poem to the great women of New Africa to pressure more on this point of mine. So, finally, I ask, why do we admit women into the political science department in the higher institution if you propose on why they should not be actively involved in politics? They say government is for the people. A woman is part of the people. With this, I rest my case. Thank you.
It's time to rescue your team. Let's hear from the lead speaker, proposing team.
Observing the existing order of protocol, I still stand to affirm that women should not be actively involved in politics. I know everybody seated here is familiar with the popular rhyme that goes, "Who sat and watched my infant head when sleeping on my cradle bed? My mother." I wonder what would have happened if my mother was actively involved in politics when I was sleeping on my cradle bed. So my opponent, tell me, if your mother was actively involved in politics, would you be seated here today? Not only females are close to their mothers. As a natural law, Oedipus Rex permits the male child to also be attracted to the mothers. Why then do we argue on? Women should not be actively involved in politics. Thank you.
Let's hear from the lead speaker, opposing team. Thank you.
Standing on the already existing order of protocol, I remain eternal, sir. To give a recap of what I, my second and third speakers, have said, we have talked about women, about achieving women in politics, past and present. But I'm here to add more to that. And before I begin, let me correct some misconception of my opponent. I asked you to give me facts. Tell me of a woman who has been reported of failing home due to active politics. But all you gave me was your words. Tell me a woman who was reported to have a failing home due to her participation in politics. But I can tell you that Funmilayo Ransome-Kuti was an active politician. Yet she had three children, one of whom was the former Minister of Health here in Nigeria. Also, God himself ordained politics. I have heard my opponent's first speaker saying that whatsoever God has joined together, let no man put asunder. And she put it in her own words by saying, whatsoever God has joined together, let politics not put asunder. But I stand to tell you that if you say this, you are actually saying a man himself should not be actively involved in politics. Because a man can be actively involved in politics and forget his duties as a husband and a father to his home. So if you say that, it means men themselves should be subtracted from the area of active politics. Also, have you forgotten about Indira Gandhi of Ghana, of India? Due in her tenure, she has made India a renowned country. India is known to have the best medical equipment and for the study of medicine. Also, if you compare countries ruled by women and countries ruled by men, you will notice that a country like Liberia, Germany, Britain, we have relative peace unlike Nigeria. Nigeria has not given her women the chance to mold the fate of the nation. That is why perhaps Nigeria still remains a grossly underdeveloped state. It is with these reasons like this and more that I strongly oppose the motion that women should not be actively involved in politics. Thank you.
It was my big sister's matriculation.
Mom,
Mom and Dad.
My.
We're so proud. And the party was quite ready. We all got a whiff of an unexpected guest.
There's a rumble in my tummy going boom, bada boom, bada boom. It means that I am hungry and me time is near. I am so excited that I can hardly wait. My mouth is getting ready to sing the Mimi song.
Take me, break me, anyway you make me. Mimi, Mimi, Lulu, Mimi, taste me, feel me.
There's more to me.
Produced by May and Baker.
Boom, shasha.
I was walking down the street on my way to the shop. Somebody said, hey, you, stop. I looked around. Well, I could see just two little boys standing next to me. He said, hey, mama, I've seen you sing. I've seen you dance and I've seen you swing. Won't you teach me how you do it? I said, akashé, love you, show boy. Every kid on earth would love to be a superstar.
At this point, I hand over to the panel of judges. Thank you.
Thank you very much. How I wish we were able to assume the status of a Jeddah who made Nigeria very proud. We go to the best speaker for today. I really want to quickly put attention. The best speaker for the day goes to Miss Usoro Etienu. Congratulations to Etienu. With another, but from the coalitions and auditions of different parties, then the winner emerges. Just a matter of 5 points away from the other. Federal Science and Tech, Uyo. Has 82 points. While Federal Government Girls College, Economy Town, Valley Local Government has 77 points. The winner is Federal Science and Technical College.
Let's put our hands for the success of today's competition. Yes, that has been the length, the breadth, and the height of today's competition. I hope you had a swell time watching of the program. We'll do this again next time, same station, on another educative topic. But until then, let's keep building a nation
where peace and justice shall reign.